Takumi is doing that.
We are live. Whew. A few technical issues this morning, but hey, listen, this is the middle of the coronavirus pandemic around the world, and it's Coach Hanson here and the team in the studio around different parts of Singapore, and we, because of social distancing, we can't come close to you, give you a hug and give you a high five, give you, but we can put our fist up. So if you're in the house, we have a few guests in the house, which we'll introduce in a second. Put your hand up, give us a high five in the morning. Social distancing at its best here in Singapore this morning, and we're streaming live on YouTube and also on Facebook. So if you're one of the first people to come into the group this morning, you will be in our guest room and you'll be able to interact with us live here. If not, you will just be on Facebook or YouTube, and you can write in the chat section and the coach will answer your questions and help you out. So on behalf of the team here at Skateboards, welcome to the Saturday morning 10 o'clock class for the level 4 to level 8 kids. Put our hands up, get some music going, and we'll welcome everybody to the show. Wherever you are, around the world, using any kind of space, at home, Zen. Who else have we got? Shout out the people's names from the 10 o'clock class. We have a lot of kids. Taylor, who else have we got? OLLI, who else have we got? Xander from that level 4 to 8 as well. Who else have we got? Keep shouting out the names and let's get this music rolling. And Thomas, I can see you with his cool helmet on. Yes, he's ready for lesson. Xander, go through a few. Zen, go through a few of the names of our students. The 10 o'clock group and the 5 o'clock group. We got Will, Josh. Who else is in the groups? Can't hear you, Zen.
Oops. All right. Okay. So we have lots. We have Anya, Felix, Elia, Jeremy, Sarah, Naya. From 5 o'clock group, we have Josh, Will, Vivian, Ethan. Yeah.
All right. So special shout out to all those guys. And remember, if you're a level 4 to 8 student, you're in the right place right now. And we're going to be doing our tricks today. And our tricks today are what, Zen? Load them up. The review from last week, our tricks number 1, 2.
Okay. So the 2 tricks from last week will be your OLLI and the OLLI 180.
All right. Cool. So we're going to get into that, but first we need to start for our warm-up. So everybody jump up out of your saddles, jump up out of your seat, whether you're at home like Zen, in the studio like Rafita, or myself in a car park in the middle of the East Coast here, we are going to get into our warm-up. So take a big breath, set up your cameras, put a spotlight on me, and Zen, you need to walk me through because I'm quite far away from the camera. Here we go.
All right. Okay, so the first exercise, if we can have a spotlight on Coach Hanson, is jogging on the spot. If you're at home and if you have lots of room, you can run front and back like him. All the way up the camera, touch your toes, jog back. And touch your toes, jog all the way to the front. And let's do it together. Come on, everybody. Let's get our heart pumping. To the front, to the back. Okay. And yeah, jumping on the spot a little bit faster.
Okay.
And slow down. All right, next. Take deep breath, breathe in.
You breathe up, I didn't look at the camera.
And breathe out.
You breathe up.
All right, breathe in.
And
breathe out.
Breathe out. Can we hear you?
Yeah.
We got our background music, guys.
All right, next is our hip exercise. All right, side to side.
Come on, guys. You can feel it. Okay.
And up and down.
Shoulders. Hands up.
Hands up.
And one. Rotate. Rotate.
slow and on the warm up, you can stretch all the way as far back as you can.
And then for the level 4 to 8, we got one extra thing, which is the elbow and the punch to really stretch out our back here. Okay, watch.
Okay, let's do it. For the punch. Fresh it up. Squeeze and punch. One. Oh, nice one. Thomas is getting it. Come on, Taylor. Punch it up.
Come on, Taylor. Come closer.
All right. Come on, Thomas. We're moving on, guys. We're moving on. We've got to keep rolling here. Come in.
Next.
Okay, Zen.
Hey, hip rotation. Round and round. Big white rolls. Stretch.
You need to mute people.
Back to going round and round.
Okay. Ready?
Okay.
Ready?
Alright. Knees together and draw circles. Alright, get some balance and just go round and round. Ooh, that's Taylor doing his warm-up.
Jump.
Hey Taylor, you're on spotlight. Everybody's watching you now. And it's Thomas. Nice new rotation.
Okay.
All right.
Ankle.
And last one, ankles. Rotate your ankles. And the other foot.
Okay.
Okay. Then you stretch your calf, back foot on the back foot. So, alright. And switch. Okay. Let's follow what Coach Hanson is doing.
Are you guys ready? Are you pumped? Look at me, I'm sweating already. We're gonna do this. Come on, guys, get back.
What's next?
If I go forward, I'm gonna come back. Ready?
Yes.
Ready?
Ooh. Five. Push ups. Let's go. How many is that? Five.
One,
two, three, four, five, and.
Ready?
Yeah. Oh, I think it's going to be a throwing rocket. Dragon rocket. Feet flat on the ground. Tuck your elbows in. And shoot off.
Easy. Just look up. Look up.
Ready? And two. Boom. Three.
Boom.
Boom. Four. Gonna explode it out. Come on, Taylor.
Especially for the higher level dragons. Thomas, I like it. Now watch the next level.
Down, muscle, load, 180.
Boom! Oh. Hey. Come on, Tommy. One full rotation, let's give it a try. One, two, three, and boom! One, two, three, and rotate. Okay, give it a try. Come on, guys. Well, make sure that you got lots of space, you're not crashing into anything. If you're in a living room like me.
And the last one.
And
ooh.
balance.
The last one. All of the superheroes. Come on.
The last exercise. What would be the last exercise?
Ready? Are you ready?
Are you ready? Your Spider-Man stretch. Hey, what? And stretch the other side. Change. Move. And go faster and faster.
Just hold it. Elbows.
Oh, elbows right beside your knee. You're gonna just balance and lean forward. Okay, so you bend your elbows and you try to see if you can balance yourself up. Look at Xander, he's doing a good job. It's great balance. Lots of strength.
Well done, you guys. Water break time. 30 seconds, 45. Come back. We see you soon.
All right. Let's have our water break.
Get some music while we wait. Did you guys have your water break?
Yep.
Cool. All right, so we're using whatever space we can use. So I'm about to flip this and show you. We've just got a small car park area here, and Xander's asked if he can be over here, which is a lot smoother, all right? So you guys find yourself a smooth spot. And if you've got neighbors... Yeah, well, if you've got your skateboard, it's ideal, right? So remember that each time that you come on a Saturday or Sunday morning class, and we're doing it live on Facebook and YouTube, you can take your phone or your iPad downstairs, somewhere which is safe and there's not people around, and just check with your mum and dad it's okay, and just go down for half an hour and try and get some air. But of course, with social distancing and the measures in place, you obviously need to follow the rules and listen to mum and dad. They'll make a decision on that. But what we do is we usually find a small space like this. Did you see anybody around? YouTube people, Facebook people? There's nobody around, right? So we're nice and safe down here. All right, so we're going to switch over to Xander, and Xander's going to refresh what we did last week, which was our Ollie Pops. We're going to do a refresher. So let's pin that one. Okay, I can see Zen, but I cannot see the main screen to be Xander.
Okay, let's pin Xander. You will recap 1 hour, Ollie's, and Ollie's 180.
Okay, here he is. All right, so Xander, turn around and go through the steps again. So you kids at home and watching live on TV, remember, this is a basic course. This is level 4 to 8, and we're just mastering the finer details of our Ollie Pop, right? So we're going to tap on the toe. We're going to slide the front foot and push it down. Okay, so it's very, very difficult to do it stationary, isn't it, right? You know that. So we're just going to show you the steps again. I'm going to change sides so you can see. Okay, Xander, take it really, really slowly. Here he goes, really slow. Look at that back foot. Just tap it up. Now, the front foot's got to roll. Yes, and you can do that again. And Roll the front foot. Yes, let's do it. And now do it a bit faster. And a bit faster. So if you've got a space at home and you're practicing, that's great. Just don't annoy the neighbors too much. All right, we're getting a bit faster. Remember, keep trying. It's very difficult to do it slow. All right, so now we're up to the actual tap. So Xander, if you don't mind, can you just show the back foot tap? Just the back foot tap. No, without being on the skateboard, you can show them the back foot tap. Just so it lifts the board up. I'm going to mute it because it's very loud.
All right, so you can see that you just need to put your back foot right at the center of the tail, and you can give it a tap. What is the important part is to get the wheels off the air. You can see that Xander does a small little push as he tap it, and that will cause the board to spin in a 360 or a 180. Right, that will be a pop shuttles. And that's a great OLLI 180. The OLLI, and the OLLI with a small shift of your back foot, so you can do it with the OLLI 180. Right, so there's a very good OLLI. You can see that he slide his foot all the way up to the nose before he push it down, so that will get the whole skateboard up into the air. A wonderful performance. If you're at home and you do not want to disturb the neighbor, then you will just have to visualize it, or you can even do it without a skateboard. Right, just pretend that you're on your air skateboard. Remember, OLLI is the most basic flatland skills, that the trick that you need in order to work on all other tricks. So this is a really important skill for you to practice. Most skaters, they probably do this like thousands and thousands of times until it is just like snap, they got it without even having to think about where to place their foot. It's just going to be a second instinct. It's a muscle memory. All right, look at Xander. He's having fun practicing. And he's just falling over the cracks. Yeah, so that is a good. And you can see that his board totally went over the crack without sliding over it. So you gotta get the air time. To get the air time, you gotta leave it all the way up and you gotta slide it forward. All right, without sliding forward, without sliding the front foot forward, you will not be able to drag your skateboard to the front and you will not be able to get over the crack successfully. Okay, one more time and it's a pop. Nice pop. Okay, thank you, Xander. All right, if you are at home, you can practice that or just visualize the step. All right, so mental visualization is very important.
Now,
really difficult, but I'll keep trying.
All right. Thanks, Xander. So that's difficult. So we're going to take a 30-second break, get a water break, and we're going to come right back live here in Singapore during COVID-19. Oh, I'd love to see you on the bed doing that, Thomas. That's a great idea, you guys. That's how you practice. Awesome, Sauce. Having a break. See you soon.
Wow, that's a great idea. Nice one, Taylor. And that's a brand new way to practice your ollies without making any noise so you will not disturb the neighbors. Woo! Wow. That's great. Very, very creative. But thumbs up for me. All right, but please make sure you got a clean skateboard. We do not want all the dirt on road getting onto your bedsheet, because that's the way you sleep at night, right? And yes, you can see Thomas practicing his ollie too. All right, have a quick drink of water, and we will come on back to the next skill.
Music and video. Maybe show Zen's video. That's an awesome one.
Ooh, and that's me practicing on my skateboard doing kick turns, front side, back side, kick turns 360, hand balance, and that's practice for rolling on the skate, pushing the front foot forward on ollie, lots of balance, leaning to the front, leaning to the back, getting away from balance, jumping over and twisting of the hips. Oh, all this in 30 seconds. Right, so you just need to do this maybe 10 minutes a day and you will be so familiar with all the skills that you'll be able to do it simply just a tap of a finger.
All right, so we have our special guests in the house. So great for you guys to join us. It's very noisy here. The guys are working on a Saturday. So I'm going to let Zen do the talking and we're going to do some actions down here, right? Because we don't want to disturb you guys with all of this noise that's going on in the background, all right? So you're live watching us on Facebook. If you're watching us on YouTube, this is the coronavirus skateboarding live here in Singapore. We're reaching out to you all. Put your comments and your likes in the thread. Support the kids who are home. They're getting bored. They need to do some exercise. They need to do some training and build up their skills ready to go back to the skate park. So support us. Lots of love, no hate. Ciao. I'm going to turn off the mic and we're going to get on to the next skills.
All right. So the next skill for our recap will be the OLLI 180. All right. So I think the most important thing after for doing an OLLI 180 is to master your OLLI and then you will be able to move on to the 180. All right. Let's take a look. Okay, so Coach Hanson is going to do a demonstration of the hips rotation. Okay, so you have to rotate your hip without moving your lower body and then you hop. Okay, so it is just like a body variant. Right. Tap, twist, and you turn. Looks easy, perfectly easy, all right, but it is very difficult to do. Get the coordination right when you are on the skateboard. Okay, so you can see Coach Hanson got the skateboard right there. Step one, the tap of the tail, right? And you got to make sure that as you twist your hip, you got to tap and turn the skateboard together. Right. Let's see whether we can see a tap and a twist of the body. All right, the rotation. Okay, here, special attention on the back foot. All right, as you tap and twist, you do it together. Okay.
So let's see some of you dragons try it. So if you've got space, I think Thomas has got space. We would like to see you try. We're going to spotlight you because you're our special guest. Remember that each show that we do, the live skateboarding here for the coronavirus, stay at home, stay isolated. We can only bring the first six kids onto the show. So you're our special guest. Thomas, let's have a look at what you're working on. Maybe we can help you.
Okay, Thomas, you are live and everybody is all eyes on you. You got a nice little ollie. And
Max, can I also show you something really funny? I'm in the middle of a lesson.
Okay, good try, Thomas. So we can see that you're doing your ollies. The three steps. Tapping on the tail. You got it? All right, is it at the center of the tail? Right, if you can do that, that would be perfect. And then you got to drag and hop at the same time. All right, so I think the time coordination is almost there, but not quite yet. So you will have to practice to get the coordination so that the board can get into the air. All right. And this is Taylor. He's going to do, Taylor, what are you going to show us? Let's take a look at the trick. The ollie. All right. You can see that he doesn't have any shoes on, but he got socks on. So we can't drag, we kind of slide the board. Otherwise, it's going to be a hole, but yes. That's pretty good. I can see that there's a bounce there. Getting the board up. And, oh, that's a good ollie.
Hey, Taylor, I got a question. Do you have a carpet in front of the bed, buddy?
Yeah.
Okay, could you jump on the carpet and give it a try? Is it going to be too much noise or too troublesome? You just need to adjust your camera because I think you're doing really, really well, mate. Can we adjust the camera or put the camera down on the ground, or is it up on a monitor? Oh, yeah, carry it down there. Let's have a look.
All right, now we got a nice clear
view. Oh, man, what a view. You are totally set up, Taylor. Whoa. Now, Taylor, just a tip, buddy. If you throw on some shoes, we give you 30 seconds to put on some shoes, mate. It's going to make a world of difference, right? Because you need a little bit of slide. All right. So I love, guys, that he's making the effort, and he's got the carpet laid out there, just like Zen does at home. And his board looks beautiful just sitting there all by itself, doesn't it? It's going to be better when he gets some shoes on. So when you're trying at home, not bare feet, not with socks on, really do put some shoes. Now, I understand that he didn't wear shoes because he was on the bed, right? All right, Zen. So let's walk him through this and give him a little bit of extra help. And you kids at home, you can watch videos all day. You can see all kinds of tricks. You can see all kinds of videos about how to do an ollie or a 180, but there's nothing quite like doing it and having somebody give you feedback straight away. And there's one way to do that is you can get a friend to video you doing the trick. And then when you play back the video to yourself and you can look at exactly what you're doing, put it in slow motion. It really, really, really will help you understand what you're doing wrong. Okay, so Zen, you're going to walk him through it?
Yes, all right.
Zander, let's, all Zander's right. Back. Oh, look.
Okay,
jump up, Taylor's right. Doing it.
Okay, let's take a look. Back for the video.
Video analysis. Okay, so what's he got?
Okay. Nice tap on the back foot. All right. And we can see that he's adjusting his front foot to the center of the foot. Yeah, that is much better. All right. So when you put your front foot at the center of the skateboard, you have more space to slide it forward. Okay, so what we can see that the tail is actually not going really high enough. So the thing that we have to do is the back foot. After you tap, you have to really lift up your back foot. And the front foot, simultaneously, you need to slide it until it touches the nose. Right, so slide all the way till it touches the nose, and you got to jump. Yeah. All right, looking, getting better. Right, just bend your knees before you press. You do not have to lift your back foot all the way to the back, somewhere to the center. Yes, better. All right, so I think what
very good.
Stopping is your front foot did not reach the nose. All right, try to. Just do the slide all the way to the nose. Yes, you gotta go all the way up. Okay, so that only went up to the screw. You gotta make sure that it touched the nose.
Right, so Taylor, put your foot in the middle first, not right at the back. That's too far back. The front foot, about the middle. No. That one goes right to the tail. That's correct. Yes, okay. No, the back foot right on the tail. Back foot right up on the tail. It's not up. Yes. Now the front foot is in the perfect spot now. Oh, it was in the perfect spot. Put it back. Put it back. Yep, a bit more. Now you've got about half the board that you can kick it and roll it. Now when your foot rolls forward or slides forward, you want to touch the tip of the board. Just practice it. Slide your left foot forward. Slide it forward. Now hit the top. Yes. Now that will lift the back wheels up. It's strange how it works, but it does work. Excellent, Taylor. I love to see that you're breaking it down and you're thinking about it. So let's move to Zander. We're going to find Zander, and he's going to do one for you. Zander Bear, come on, buddy. We are ready for you. Oh, he's over there. Okay, grab your board, and I'm going to switch it around, and let's see the actual ollie. All right. Ollie pop 180. Okay, stationary. Stationary. Okay. Okay, so we had a bit of an issue last week. Everybody's got bad habits or habits that you've done many, many, many times and they don't help you. Now, for Zander, I found that one of his issues was he wasn't turning his head. So if you have a look at him now, let's see if he can get all the way around, nearly all the way around. So give us a high five. If you're the guest in the room, give us some high fives for Zander. Oof. Now, if I just put this here for a second, and I'm just going to help Zander while Zen can probably help. Watch this.
All right, so what we are paying attention is the direction his body and his head Alright, so you can see that he's now facing Coach Hanson. He should be facing the walls and looking. And as he do an ollie, he got a twist. He got to make sure that his feet and his head and his body turns all the way around. And when he lands, he should be facing the camera. Right, from the back facing the camera, he got to do an ollie 180. And when he lands, his front should be facing the camera. Okay, so he's going to try it out with a twist. Right, and getting on the board. Back facing the camera, he's turning his head. Right, leaving with his head and his hands. Then his body will follow through. And finally, his feet will follow all the way around. And his skateboard will do an ollie 180. Let's take a look. Right. So that's a much better turn. He did not manage to land it though. Let's see if he will give it another try. Right. Okay, leading with the heads and the hand, finally it goes with the body around to with the skateboard. Okay, yeah, so it does take lots and lots of practice, and this skill is a more advanced version. All right, getting there. All right, it's really it's just a more advanced version of the body barrier, right? So with the body barrier, this time you want to make sure that you bring the board along with you. That will be the ollie. Right, so we can see that it's getting there. All right, neat one. He landed it. And you can see that when he lands it, his body is right around.
Okay, last one, because we don't want to disturb the neighbors, all right? So we're going to do the last one. There's neighbors who live here. We don't want to disturb them, all right? Whoa! Give him some celebration. All right. So we're going to take it over onto a rough surface and see if he can do it over here. Xander. So, Thomas, let's see yours. Who else is in the house? Taylor is our guest as well today on the show. And ladies and gentlemen, we're going live around the world, Facebook, YouTube. And this is the first time we've done both channels at the same time, using whatever space we can get. Now, we're going to go over to Thomas. Thomas, if you could adjust your monitor or your camera down a little bit so we can see your feet, it would be really, really awesome.
Okay, I think that would do.
Give that a try. Give that a
setback. Okay, this will do, Thomas. All right, Thomas. Okay, Thomas, you're on mute, so we can't hear you. But all right, maybe you can take two steps back and we'll be able to see your skateboard. You want to see it? All right, yes, now we can see your skateboard.
Love it, love it, love it.
All right, ollie. How about the ollie 180? Let's try it. Not confident yet. It's all right.
It's okay.
Right. Let's try it. All right. A good twist. Remember, bend your
knees. Remember, rotate your shoulders. Boom. Right. He got the shoulder rotation. That was a good start. Good one, Thomas.
Okay, let's try one more time, Thomas. All right, so bend your knees before you do the pop. It will be much easier for you to do the rotation. All right, getting there. Good one. I think that's almost a 90-degree turn. All right. Okay, yes. So lots and lots of effort needed to land this trick. Right, it's a really difficult trick. Okay, how about Taylor? Is Taylor in the house? Hey, thank you, Thomas. Okay, Taylor is ready. I'm gonna give it a try. Okay, turn. Oh, that's a nice turn. Not much of a pop. Okay, let's see if we can get a pop and a turn together. Hey. That looks like a pop, shall it? Alright, that was your habit. I remember as you do a turn, you have to do a body variation together in the air. Alright, don't sit the board around, you got to twist your body around. Okay, bend your knees, get ready for the ollie. Front foot right. Oh yes, much better. You can see the twist of the body. Alright, that rotation is really, really important. Alright, so if you can get the timing right, do the rotation as you pop the board into the air, the board will come together with you. Right, a bit like a big turn, a bit like the body variation. It's all about the rotation of the body. Oh yes, that's a good one. Oh yes, and landed it. He's staying right on top of the board now. Right, very good. Very good try. Nice attempt. You can see that there's a 90-degree turn already. Okay, so sometimes you see that Taylor, you're landing off the skateboard. So that could be probably because you don't have enough practice, right? So you're not confident. Right, so with practice, you'll get more. With the knowledge and the experience, you'll get really much better. You'll get a proficiency in it, and then you'll be able to do it and land on it 100% of the time. Okay, yes, all right, so it is 10:40 now. We're going to move on to our trip for today. Maybe a quick water break, and then we can go back to Hanson. Oh, Hanson is gone, and he's back. Right, a quick water break, and when we come back, we'll find out what is the trick for today. Oh yes, and I noticed that there was a notebook somewhere lying in the room just now with Taylor. So it could be a good idea for you if you would like to write it down. Write down the tips, write down the steps that you need so that you can remember them after the video. Or you can just come on back to the YouTube, click on the link on the YouTube live, and you will be able to just watch a recap anytime you want. So you will be able to remember, you will be able to refresh yourself on the skills and on the steps that you need in case you forget. All right, a quick water break and we are back. Maybe we can have a quick message from Coach Vic. Let's see if Coach Rafida can play the message from Coach Vic. Right, so with the COVID virus around, Coach Vic is not able to attend our classes, but he still have got a message for everybody. Oh no, we can't hear him.
I can.
You can hear him?
Yeah.
All right.
Oh, I can't hear him now.
Oh, you can't hear him. Right. Well, we will share the video into our group. So later, you will be able to see Coach Vic's message, right? Okay, let's see whether Coach Hanson is back. Coach Hanson, are you there? Coach Hanson. All right, looks like he's not here. Alright, so time is running low. We are running out of time soon. It's 10:45 and we will have to do a quick discussion. Alright, so let's go on back to our steps. Today, what did we do today? What are the two skills that we kept on? who got it, give me a thumbs up if you got it.
OLLI,
yes, really, OLLI. Okay, and what is the second one?
OLLI pop.
Isn't that the same as OLLI? OLLI and OLLI pop. Maybe I'm not familiar with the name, but it's OLLI one something something.
OLLI 160.
OLLI 160. It's OLLI 180. All right. So the name OLLI 180, it comes from 180 means the degree, right? So a full circle is 360 degrees. So OLLI 180 simply means you do an OLLI and you turn half around. So that is OLLI 180. All right. So tips for the OLLI, we gotta make sure that our back foot is right on the center of the tail. Front foot, we normally start it somewhere around the middle of the board, and we have to slide it all the way up to the nose so that the back wheel can lift up. All right, so maybe for a quick sharing session, we can share about your personal weakness and what you need to look out for, back foot or front foot. Okay, how about Thomas? Thomas, what do you need to do? What do you need to focus on to improve your OLLI?
Practice and camera.
You need to practice. All right. Oh, we have a live spotlight on Hanson now. Okay, welcome back, Coach Hanson.
Yeah, I'm listening to Thomas. It's lovely. Thanks, Thomas.
Okay, Thomas. So what do you need to focus on your practice?
Getting my back wheel off the ground.
Getting your back wheel off the ground. And you do that by?
What's that?
How do you do that? How do you get a back wheel off the ground?
By moving my front foot.
All right, by moving your front foot. All right, lots of the sliding of your front foot. Okay, so that will be good practice. All right, thank you for sharing. Let's move on to Taylor. How about you, Taylor? What is your weakness? What is the step that you need to pay special attention to when you're doing an OLLI?
I think dragging my foot.
Dragging your foot? From where to where?
And I need to put all the steps together.
You need to put all the steps together. All right. Okay, so yes, very good. From what I saw just now, I think you guys got the point correct. So for Thomas, you just need to practice sliding the board. And for Taylor, you have to practice getting your front foot really sliding it all the way to the nose. All right. So if you got it all the way up to the nose, I'm sure your OLLI will get so much higher and so much better. All right. And let's zoom in to Coach Hanson. Coach Hanson, anything for us? And Zander?
Yeah, Zander, you got any sharing today about what we're doing, the OLLI pop and the pop 180? You got anything?
No.
Just share what do you think of the guys today?
I didn't see them because I was.
Oh, he was too busy doing it. Okay. So what's a little tip you can give them about the pop 180? What do you really need to work on to get that 180? Remember we're talking about your upper body rotation? What do you need to do with your head and your shoulders?
I turn.
Yeah, so rotate your head and your shoulders is the key, yeah? All right, cool. Must be able to OLLI, he says. Yeah, so it's been absolutely awesome having our two guests on today. So each time that we come live, you guys, Taylor, and who have we got there, Thomas, we can only take the first six people to come on live with us. So we really appreciate you coming on early and being one of the first six. And everybody else will watch you on YouTube or watch you on Facebook. And it's a great way to learn. And more importantly for me, I find that it's a great way for us to stay connected and stay positive and work on some tricks at home and we can show off. So that leads me into your challenge for this week. All right. So this week, we need you guys to practice and take a video or a photo of you doing some tricks. And ideally, it will be the OLLI And we want to get those wheels off the ground, you know, progressively off the ground. So if you can get somebody, or you can set up your camera so you can get a video of it and you send it into us, you can be featured on the show. And so we're looking at certain different prizes to bring up for you guys as well. People who put in the extra effort get lots of rewards, not only financially or gifts or something, but they get the most improvement. So kudos to you guys. Congratulations to you guys for coming on today and putting in the effort. I'm really, really impressed with you guys so much. And so on behalf of me, Xander, and the team here in coronavirus lockdown Singapore, and all of our friends around the world, we wish you guys an awesome day and an awesome weekend of virtual skateboarding at home, or in your case, practicing on a yoga mat or on a bed or anywhere. You can still practice. And when this is all over, which it will be over, we will be revving into the park while all those other guys who are sitting at home just watching video games and stuff like that, they're not going to be revved and ready and prepared. They're not going to have the strength and stability and to go out there in the park and shred the park, whereas you guys will be able to shred it like a real dragon. So can I have a fist up for the dragon, and we say it together to finish off our day? Remember, you've got a challenge, and the challenge is what? To take a photo of a video of your tricks and post it in the group so we can recognize you as a star. All right, put our fists up, and we go. Let's do it together, okay? Roll in, drop ins, okay? Roll in, drop in, ollie, hops. Dragons will always be on top. D-R-A-G-O-N-S. Dragons. Rock. You guys have a wonderful weekend. Over to you, Zen. Over to you, Rafita, in the studio.
All right. Thank you very much for attending. We will see you again next week. All right. Bye, everybody.
Bye.